Edwin Okon is with us in the studio. And of course, Moses Aduko is the coach of Bayelsa Queens, both brothers from the South Sabo. Good to have you guys in the studio.
Thank you very much.
Okay, so let me begin with Coach Edwin Okon. He's closer. Let's look at women's football so far in Nigeria. Is it developing?
Yes. I want to say it has come of age. The development is so much as it concerns women from football. But we are still crying. Mm. And the area we are crying is just that of sponsors. Once we get the sponsors, like as I said earlier on today, I think the country, what we see in the country, I think you won't even compare to what you see in Sweden and America. Mm. So we just want that corporate bodies to come in and assist the house.
Support. Yes. Coach Moses, Bayelsa Queens, you guys have been making remarkable progress in the last two seasons. And I must say, I love the football that Bayelsa Queens plays. What has been responsible for this admiration that you guys are giving the world?
Just simple hard work. Hard work. They work hard, very hard now. The players are determined to play. So that is what you get. When you work hard, you get results.
Yeah, I know, and I see that you guys are putting that into it. Let me let the viewers know what happened. When we were setting up these coaches to start the show, and I whispered, who is going to win the Super Four? Coach Edwin Okon said Rivers Angels, and he said talk is cheap. Let me bring the talk back here now. For this year's Super Four, last year was competitive. I loved it. What should we be expecting this year, Coach Edwin Okon?
Same thing as that of last year, but the way it step forward. Because yesterday is gone, today is another day. And what happened yesterday, you just have to put it by the side and then think of way forward. And at that level, I think in Benin, so many things come to play, and I do well by the special grace of God. Teams are aware of that, and every team has had today. Mm. Just people can sit back and say, ah, yesterday, this is how I lost to Aduku. Aduku lost to me. I just want to correct those mistakes. Yeah. So every team has had now, and if you check through, if you look at the four teams that qualify at this level,
they're on fire.
Teams at any time, any day that the wins them up, they will give you whatever team you want. So, seeing the teams that are qualified for the Super Four this season, I claim champion of the season.
Mm. I know. I'll come back to you on Nasara Amazons for tomorrow. Let me talk to Coach Moses. It's Sunshine Queens, and this season, Sunshine Queens showed us that you cannot underrate them. How are you going to approach that match?
It's going to be a good game because any team that qualifies for Super Four, you know they are a good team. So we are going to approach it the way how we have approached the games from the time I joined the team, mid-season. And I feel at the end of the day, we'll come out victorious.
I love the story coming out of Bayelsa Queens. So tell me, how challenging is it to manage a female football team?
Anyway, it is very, very interesting. I've been there before, you know, before I came back again. But it's interesting. But when you see women playing football, you see them playing good football, you love them.
Yeah.
You know, and that is what people are going to see tomorrow. The four teams are going to play good football, you know. But definitely, the better team will carry the day.
That's what it is. The better team will definitely. We Rivers Angels have been dominating women's football for some time now, Coach Edwin Okon. But at last year's Super Four, I don't know if you're still disappointed, but it's Nasarawa Amazons once again tomorrow.
Yeah, I think once beaten, twice shy. Like as I said before, now that you just have to go back home and then think of what went wrong as at yesterday, and try as much as you can to see as you can as well correct those mistakes. It's not an easy job working with a female team. It is better you get to under 10 boys, and then take care of them as a coach, as a technical advisor. But when it gets to the female, it's a very hectic job because anything goes. Female can as well get up within during the halftime, the 15 minutes break and tell you that is this happened, that happened, and this happened. And it can happen to three, four, five players. Well, you had only three changes. And so you as a female coach, it's a very hectic job managing these children at that level to get the result. It's not easy coaching female football.
Mm.
And for those of us that have been in that system for quite some time, I think you just decided to say, okay, if she is my daughter, what will I do?
Yeah.
That is how it goes.
Coach Moses, people say our league is getting better and we're getting to, you know, develop players from the league. The league must be viable. In what ways can we have a productive league?
Just like my coach said, sponsorship is very important. The talents are there.
Yeah.
But without sponsorship, it's difficult. Sponsorship must come in at this particular time. Then they should be looking on how the female team could also play continental games. It will help the league to grow more.
Yeah, and CAF needs to consider that.
Yes. Mm. Yes. You know, just to play the league alone and end it here is not good enough. If we can start from the West African countries, if CAF can do that, start from where it will build up the players the more.
Mm. Before I let you coaches, leave, let's just touch base with the Super Falcons. You've managed that team before, a year that you've been raising concerns as we get ready for the World Cup. What are your worries for the Super Falcons as they prepare?
Yes, I think a little rise, as one just said it. And I am worried because, as you can see now, the list of the Super Falcons, the home base, are not carried along. It gives me so much worries because if you look at this Super 4, even the ITU Cup, the talents are there in this country. And if you can as well say, okay, we build today as against tomorrow, not just to build only today, after today, then we'll sleep. Now, I think our focus should be who takes over from Precious Dede? Who takes over from Stellan Bachu? Who takes over from this old Onomi? Who takes over from them in case they retire today? I think we'll start something for today against tomorrow.
Mm.
And not to rely on only those that are in. I think by His Grace, if you look at the bulk of the Super Falcons players today, those are the ones that travel away from under 20 to the Super Falcons. And since after that, I think there's no new intake.
Maybe Rashida.
Oh, just a Rashida and Anaimo into the system. And we have so much talent here in this country. Let's think of how to build today for tomorrow. And not just to build today for today. After now, it becomes a problem to the country.
Yeah.
So,
I get you. Thank you. Thank you so much, Coach Edwin Okon and Coach Moses Aduko. Thank you so much. I want to wish all the four teams the best of luck. Let the best team win.
Thank you. Man, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you so much.